My name is Susan Sytsma Bratt, and I serve as the senior pastor here at Crossroads. On behalf of our congregation and the family of Dorothy Beers, welcome to this service of resurrection of life. Following the service, you are invited to greet the family in the narthex and to stay for a reception. And you might be sure to grab a dark Dove chocolate, because that was Dorothy's favorite. Please join me in our responsive call to worship found in your bulletin. As many of you as were baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves with Christ. In her baptism, Dorothy was clothed with Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, she shall be clothed with glory. Let us worship God. You're invited to stand and sing hymn number 467, which can be found in the blue hymnals in your pew racks.
Consider all the worlds thy hand. the grace of God overflows for us through Christ Jesus, who came into the world to save sinners. So let us now ask God to cleanse our hearts, to redeem our memories, and to renew our confidence in the goodness of God as we confess our sin together and by praying and saying, Holy God, you see us as we are and know our inmost thoughts. We forget that all life comes from you and that to you all life returns. We have not always sought or done your will. We have not lived as your grateful children, nor loved as you love us. Apart from you, we are nothing. Only your grace can sustain us. Lord, in your mercy, forgive us, heal us, and make us whole. Set us free from our sin, and restore to us the joy of your salvation, now and forever. Amen. Hear the good news. Who is in a position to condemn us? Only Jesus Christ. And Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ reigns in power for us. Christ prays for you and for me. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old has gone. New life has begun. Friends, know that you are forgiven. And be at peace. Let us pray. Almighty God, source of all true wisdom, calm the troubled waters of our hearts and still all other voices but your own, that we may hear and obey what you tell us in your word through the power of your Spirit. Amen. Our first reading is found in the Old Testament in the Psalter. Some familiar, wonderful, comforting words from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Here ends our reading.
And from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 7, we have Jesus addressing his disciples about his death and about the gift of heaven. Do not let your hearts be troubled, but believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to them, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. And from Paul's letters to the church at Rome, chapter 8, verses 35 through 39. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? No, in all these things, you're more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. From the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 through 4. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from heaven, from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them, and they will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." Friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, today we gather to remember and to celebrate the life of Dorothy Beers. We also gather to bear witness to the hope from which she lived her life. This afternoon, we have four powerful passages. The first from Psalm 23 is a beautiful reminder that God is our shepherd, providing for us wherever we are, whether we are in the valley of the shadow of death or on the mountaintops of life. And the second from the Gospel of John reminds us that Christ has prepared a place for us. And the gift of heaven is that it's a place of abundant love. It's spacious. There's peace there. From Romans, we have a passage, a promise, that nothing, absolutely nothing, can separate us from God's love. And then from Revelation, we have a picture of this love, of God wiping every tear from our eye and working to make all things new. Each of these passages the family picked contains promises of God's love, God's grace, God's provision through all the seasons of life. And these are promises that shaped Dorothy's life and that she staked her life on. These are promises from which Dorothy lived her life here at this church. Dorothy had so many gifts, and there are many things to share about her. But as I've gotten to know her over the last year and a half, and again through her family, three gifts stand out: her joy, her honesty, and her character. Dorothy was a woman who delighted in life. Whether she was out on the town in social circles with her husband, or she was here at church working the crowd during coffee hour, Dorothy was a joy and a delight to be with. She had a vibrant life, and she lived it to the fullest, and joy just emanated from her whenever you were around her. Which leads me to her second gift, which is honesty. You knew exactly where Dorothy stood. Whether you were in a Bible study conversation or a session meeting or perhaps a council meeting of Cedarburg as an alderman, Dorothy spoke her mind from a place of love, from a place of integrity. Now, Dorothy was honest about her gifts. She was not the best cook or baker, but she had other gifts to share, and her organizational and leadership gifts were stupendous. Chris shared that one day Dorothy came home and said she had volunteered for something at church. She was in charge of the pie festival, and it was very quiet around the table. The children and husband were kind of wondering where this was going, because Dorothy was not known for her cooking or her baking. And she laughed and she said, "Don't worry, I'm not baking them, I'm just organizing them. Other people will bake them." She didn't need to bake a thing because Dorothy knew how to pull on the gifts of people around her and make an event happen in a marvelous way, which embodies her gift of honesty. She knew who she was, what her gifts were, what her strengths were, and she knew her limits. And this made her a natural with all age groups. She was tapped for leadership wherever she was. Here at the church, she was an elder on the session. She was active in Bible studies. She taught preschool. She was active in vacation Bible school. And her husband, Jim, was a singer in the choir, lending his voice. They were active in North Shore Presbyterian, but when they downsized to a condo in Cedarburg, they jumped right in here at Crossroads. And we are the richer for it. Dorothy wasn't always warm and fuzzy with small children, but at Crossroads, this side of her emerged. She was the preschool grandma to all of our children who came through Crossroads Christian Preschool. Especially for those kids who had family from out of town, Dorothy was their touchstone. And not just in the classroom here Monday through Friday, but on Sunday mornings, she made a point of getting to know the children. She was active with our vacation Bible school, but perhaps her gifts were strongest as an elder on our session. Our church has had some difficult times, and Dorothy served several terms, her most recent term in her late 80s, during a time of turmoil. And Dorothy's steady, honest leadership helped to carry this congregation through. Dorothy loved passionately and deeply her family, her friends, her community, this church, and she was a gift to many. In her recent years, as her health was failing, she kept coming. She was here every Sunday when she could be here, and she was an active member of the pastor's Bible study from my first day on the job. And by active, I mean honest, direct. She shared her insights in scripture. She poked, she prodded with that smile on her face, with her red lipstick, and the conversation was richer and fuller for her presence. I spoke with her by phone several times throughout the pandemic, and I asked her, what was it like in 1918? And she said, well, we just went with the flow. It was fine. God provided. We'll get through this. Very positive and filled with joy. Each of these gifts, her joy, her honesty, and her character, sprang from a deeper place. They are gifts that our Creator God gave to Dorothy and that she used and stewarded throughout her rich and long lifetime. And even today, she's giving us a gift. I don't know if you noticed, but we have tents set up on our front lawn for the 130 or 40 kids that are coming to Vacation Bible School tomorrow. And I said to Chris, we're setting up for VBS, is that okay? And she said, absolutely. As Dorothy would have said, life goes on. And VBS is the lifeblood of a church. So today we're surrounded by signs of life of the next generation, a generation that Dorothy sought to shape and instill faith and love and generosity in. And so today we grieve. I grieve. Because Dorothy shaped each of us. But let us be clear about what we grieve. We don't grieve for Dorothy because at this moment she is a new creation with her Lord and Savior, probably driving a red convertible. We grieve for that part of ourselves that she shaped. We will miss her joy, her honesty, her character, her love. So today, as we part ways, we seek to share that same generous love with one another that Dorothy shared with us. Well done, good and faithful servant. She has entered into the joy that her Savior has prepared. Amen. Let us pray together. God of grace and love, we thank you for Dorothy. For the gift of her life, for all in her that was good and kind and faithful, for the grace you gave her. We thank you for the love that she gave to others, for the many lives she touched. And we thank you that for Dorothy, death is past, pain and illness has ended, and that she's entered the joy that you have prepared. And so today, provide comfort and hope for this gathered congregation of family and friends, that in the days to come, they would remember with joy the times they shared with Dorothy. Grant us, oh dear God, in all of our duties, your help, in all of our uncertainties, your guidance, and in all of our dangers, your protection, and in our sorrow, your peace. We thank you for the gift of life and for the gift of new life. In your Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. And now we will get to appreciate the Lord's Prayer, sung by Jenny O'Connor.
Our Father. us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Please rise for the commendation. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God Dorothy Beers. Her baptism is now complete, and she is a new creation. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, a sheep of your own flock, a lamb of your own fold. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the glorious company of the communion of saints. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors and their works follow them. Amen. And now we will sing together On Eagle's Wings, found in your bulletin.
You darling.
Amen. And now receive this benediction. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit go with us all. Amen. Please be seated. The ushers will release us by pew. Sorry.